Good day to everyone. Today we will see how the three-phase AC electricity works and how its voltage curves advance on its sinusoidal paths. Further, let's discuss involvement of square root 3 when three-phase power is calculated. We know three-phase power can be supplied to a load through a generator of our own or from a three-phase connection received from an electricity company. Although we take the supply from different sources, the generation part of the main power plants is almost the same and is a generator or an alternator with star connected windings. Generator windings are normally star connected for technical and economic reasons and mainly to get the neutral connection needed for three-phase unbalanced load conditions. Further, phase voltage of a star connected winding for a fixed line voltage is 1.732 times less compared to a delta connected winding. This will lower the cost of insulation, giving the star connected winding an economical advantage over the delta connected winding. Neutral line of the star connection is normally grounded with a neutral grounding resistor. Neutral grounding resistor is used mainly to limit the ground fault current to a safe level so that all the equipment connected to that system is protected. If you turn the magnetic field on the rotor of a generator, voltage, also called electromotive force, is generated on the field windings. Although the generator shown here is with 6 poles, let's consider the basic 3-pole generator for explaining. To understand easily, let's take the coil voltages on phase windings out like this, with the U1, V1 and W1 terminals marked on it. You will see, when the magnet is rotating, voltage generated becomes zero at a point, and that is when the magnet is perpendicular to the coil set. Magnetic field has no effect on the coil set when it is at an angle of 90 degrees with it. Here the red color phase taken as reference, and after the magnet passes this zero voltage point, voltage reverses its path, and the relevant current flow on this line too will be on the reverse direction now. The maximum voltage is generated when the north end of magnet reaches the relevant pole with winding. When the magnet rotates one full turn, voltage generated on a phase winding will reach its maximum value twice, but since these two values are on opposite directions, we call it as maximum and minimum values. Further, you will see the animated speed of the rotor is half revolution per second here. But actual speed of a three-phase, three-pole generator supplying a voltage at a frequency of 50 Hz is 3000 RPM. That is a speed of 50 revolutions per second. Now the speed has been increased to 2.5 revolutions per second. That is 150 RPM. To get the actual speed of 50 revolutions per second, that is 3000 RPM, you need to increase this speed by another 20 times. Here, the three-phase voltages are more explaining, shown with 120 degrees apart from each other. Sinusoidal waveform behavior is shown on the graph with slow speed, and as previously said, actual speed of this will be 50 sine wave cycles per second and will not be noticeable to the naked eye. So you will realize now how fast this generated voltage alternates and why the RMS value of voltage is used instead of rapidly changing alternating voltage values for calculation work on AC electricity. Please note that with a 6-pole generator, the speed of the rotor will be 1500 RPM. Further, please note, frequency of supply voltage is 50 Hz in Europe and many other countries, but is 60 Hz in North America and most parts of the Japan. Let's see how single-phase voltage sine wave advances with time in slow motion. Now you will see the RMS voltage value 2 on the same graph, and is the value to be used for single phase AC calculations. Although the single phase voltage value is fluctuating rapidly between +325 and -325, we use 230 volts as continuous voltage value for calculations. For single phase power calculation, equation is P equals V multiplied by I, multiplied by power factor given as cos phi. ATP is to be used with watts, and will be available on the nameplate of the machine. Voltage here is 230 volts, since the calculation is for single phase power. I is the current measured in amperes, and we may have to find it through this equation, related to the rated power given by watts. Power factor is given on the nameplate of the machine. When it comes to three-phase power, you will see, yellow and blue phases lag the red phase, by 120 degrees and 240 degrees respectively. Then, all three-phase voltages continue to advance on their sinusoidal wave path, keeping the 120-degree distance from each other. Here too, three individual voltages fluctuate between plus 325 and minus 325 volts, but if you measure voltage between two phases, it will be 400 volts. We stop advancing of curves when blue phase reaches zero, and you will see, the yellow and red phases has same value at this point, but one is positive and the other one is negative. So, the resultant total value of voltages is zero here. If you measure and see the voltages at any given point, the result is the same. So, if you connect a three-phase induction motor, or any other balanced three-phase load to the three-phase line, current flow on three lines also behave like this, and the resultant total current will be zero. That means, in a balanced load condition of a three-phase line, no current will flow on the neutral wire. For three-phase power calculation, let's consider star connection first, and you will see, the phase voltages has 230 volts, and the voltage between lines is always 400 volts. It is mentioned below also, that line voltage is equal to, square root 3 times phase voltage. Further, line current equals to phase current, in a star connection. When calculating power, we can use single phase equation on three individual phases, and multiply it by 3, to get the final power on three phase line. So we get, V phase, into I phase, into cos phi, multiplied by 3, for three phase power in watts to get the line condition here. We replace V phase, with V line divided by square root 3, and I phase, directly with I line. For 3 here, we can expand and write square root 3 into square root 3. So, 1 square root 3 on top, will be cancels off, with the 1 at the bottom. Only 1 square root 3 remains on top now, and the final equation for three-phase power in watts is, P equals, square root 3, multiplied by V line, multiplied by I line, multiplied by cos phi. Let's consider delta connection for calculation now. Here you see, V line equals coil voltage or V phase, but I line equals, I phase multiplied by square root 3. Let's use, single phase equation on three individual phases, and multiply it by 3, as done previously for star connection. So we get, V phase, into I phase, into cos phi, multiplied by 3, for 3 phase power in watts. To get the line condition here, V phase can be replaced directly with V line, and I phase will be replaced with I line divided by square root 3. When 3 on top is written as, square root 3 into square root 3, 1 square root 3 on top, will cancels off with the bottom one, as happened previously in star connection. Here too, the final equation for three-phase power in watts is, P equals, square root 3, multiplied by V line, multiplied by I line, multiplied by cos phi. So you will understand now, from where this multiplying with square root 3 comes from, for three-phase alternating current power calculations. If you think that this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.